Mars.
So your question was that, how come we read the Bible, whoever they're bringing out, the way we're bringing it out, but the elect, or the Christians, the pastors that are in church today, they get a whole different interpretation. And I said, yes. See,
bring it out.
Our pastors are misleading our people.
Right.
Our pastors are only in the churches for their pockets. They are lining their pockets with their members' money. And the members go into church sinners and they leave sinners.
That's right.
That. Isaiah chapter 56, verse 11.
Bring it out.
Yeah. They are greedy dogs.
Verse 10.
His watchmen are blind. So the watchmen of the 12 tribes of Israel are blind. We don't have watchmen nowadays. God chose the children of Israel as his people. Right? You understand that?
Right, yeah.
You understand Moses leading the children of Israel out of Egypt and giving them the laws that were commanded by him to give to the children of Israel, right? Right. So God chose these people. He gave these people his laws.
Right.
So nobody else can sin that don't have these laws. Only blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans can sin. So the leaders of our people, we don't have leaders right now. We're on the bottom. There's no one, there's not people or members leading our people in the right direction anymore. Read that again for the top.
His watchmen are blind. They are all ignorant. They are all dumb dogs.
This is talking about the leaders or the so-called leaders of our people today, which will be your pastors, your evangelists. You get me? Read on.
They cannot work, sleep, lying down, loving to slumber. Yeah, they are greedy dogs.
Our pastors are greedy dogs. They just taking our money, greedy.
Which can never have enough.
Right. They'll never get enough. They sing a song, Pastor Lex play it around. Sing another song, Pastor Lex play it around. Right. They just constantly taking the people's money. They're not telling the people that they're in sin.
Right. And they are shepherds that cannot understand.
They are shepherds that cannot understand. Why can't they understand? Because they're not keeping the Most High laws, statutes, and commandments.
Right.
Give me some money. They're not keeping the Most High laws, statutes, and commandments. You will get no understanding out of this Bible until you start keeping the Most High commandments. Read.
Psalms chapter 111 and verse 10. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
So the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. This is how you begin to even get wisdom to start with. You must fear the Most High God.
Right. A good understanding.
A what?
A good understanding have all they that do his commandments. Ezekiel chapter 22 verse 26. A priest has violated my law.
They have done what?
Violated my law.
So these pastors have violated the laws of God.
And have profaned my holy things.
They have profaned the holy things. Read on.
They have put no difference between the holy and profane.
They have put no difference between the holy and the profane. How is that? How have they put no difference between the holy, which is the law, statutes, and commandments in this Bible, and the profane? One is because you keep the Lord's day on when? They keep the Lord's day on when? On a Sunday. The Lord's day is the seventh day. It says, 6 days shall thou labor, and in the seventh day thou shalt keep it holy. But they don't do that. They keep the first day. Read on.
Neither have they shown difference between the unclean and the clean.
They have not shown a difference between the clean and the unclean. Right, they eat pork. They are constantly breaking God's commandments. You understand that? Read on.
And have hid their eyes from my Sabbath.
They done what?
Have hid their eyes from my Sabbath.
They have hid their eyes from the Most High God's Sabbath.
When they get to any day could be the Sabbath. Have you heard that?
It's made up. That's where they get it from. They get it from the oppressor, the so-called white man.
Right.
In slavery, they kept Sunday as a Sabbath day. So throughout history, what did Negroes do? They started keeping the same day that Master kept.
Right.
Read that.
Daniel chapter 7, verse 25. And he shall speak great words against the Most High, and shall wear out the saints of the Most High.
Who are the saints of the Most High?
No!
Huh?
The saints of God.
Yeah, who are the saints? Would it be the prophets? Let's see. Let's see what the Bible says. Understand, we're not here to speak our own words. The Bible interprets itself.
Right.
We don't have to interpret the Bible. The Bible explains itself. But our pastors, again, they don't do this. You got that? You got it?
Psalms chapter 148 and verse 14.
So we're about to find out who the saints are. Read.
He also exalted the horn of his people, the praise of all his saints, even of the children of Israel.
So who are the saints?
The followers of the Lord.
Read it again. Listen.
Psalms 148 and verse 14.
Bring it out.
He also exalted the horn of his people.
He exalted the horn of his people.
The praise of all his saints. Even of the children of Israel.
So who are the saints? The children of Israel.
That's right.
The people on this sign right here. The so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
That's right.
You saw that up on the sign?
Yeah,
you've been standing for a while. Do you see yourself on this sign?
The sign's not in the Bible. So.
Listen.
That's my question.
Okay, so you don't see yourself in this sign. So we're not talking to you. We're only here for you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. If you are not of the children of Israel, this Bible does not pertain to you. Understand that this is the concept that they've been teaching us for so many years. That this Bible is for everybody.
Bring it out.
That this is a religious book.
Right.
That everybody can worship God. That is not what the Bible says.
Right.
Psalms 147 and verse 19.
Bring it out.
He showeth his word unto Jacob.
He showeth his word unto Jacob. Jacob's name was changed to Israel. He had 12 sons.
Right.
These are the names of his sons. Judah, Benjamin, Levi, Ephraim, Manasseh, Simeon.
Bring it out.
Zebulun, Gad, Reuben, Asher.
Bring it out.
Nathanael. These are the sons of Jacob whose name was changed to Israel.
Right.
Read from the top again.
Psalms 147, verse 19.
Uh-huh.
He showed his word unto Jacob.
So he showed his word unto Jacob. Read.
His statutes and his judgments unto Israel.
He showed his statutes and his judgments to Israel. Read on.
He have not dealt so with any nation.
He has not what?
Dealt so with any nation.
So he has not dealt so, given his laws, statutes, and commandments to anyone else.
Right.
Except for the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. Give me Joel 2:27.
Bring it up.
You gotta understand this. God is only the God of you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
That's right.
Everything else is a damn lie.
That's right.
Joel chapter 2, verse 27. And ye shall know.
Say what?
And ye shall know.
You're gonna know, brother,
that I am in the midst of Israel.
That God is in the midst of Israel.
And that I am the Lord your God.
Uh-huh.
And none else.
And
none else.
You are the God of Christians.
I am the Lord your God. And none else.
He's not the God of Muslims.
I am the Lord your God. And none else.
Right. He's not the God of Esau, the so-called white man.
And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel.
Uh-huh.
And that I am the Lord your God.
He's the Lord your God and none else.
That's
none
right.
That's right.
What are we reading? The Holy Bible.
That's right.
We've been reading the Bible since the Bible was written. But your oppressor has taught you that this is. Where's the bastard? Hold this bastard up right here. Hold up this bastard, this criminal that's going into slavery.
Bring it out!
Bring it up!
Your oppressor has taught you that this is Christ. Is he in the Bible?
That is not a.
Is this image in the Bible? Let's see what the Bible says Christ looks like.
Bring it out!
Revelation chapter 1 and verse 14.
What does the word revelation mean?
To reveal.
To reveal. This is the revealing of Christ. Why does Christ have to be revealed again? Because our oppressor lied and said this bastard was Christ.
Revelation chapter 1 verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
So this is a depiction of what Christ looks like. We never said that this is Christ. We are saying that the Bible describes Christ looking like this.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
He said his head and his hairs were white like wool. Take your head off, brother. Your hair is white and woolly.
That's right.
Your hair is white and woolly. What's wrong with this picture right here? His hair ain't white and his damn sure ain't woolly.
That's right.
This is dog So his head was white and his beard was white. Read on.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
Oh, and his eyes were a flame of fire.
Hey, stay on post, man.
Because we're going to get the understanding of
the book. Hey, what is Romans 10:13?
We're not here for you. See, when we start teaching our people, when we start educating our people, the so-called white man gets mad. You know why? Because he wants you to remain ignorant.
That's right.
He wants you to keep signing
up.
He wants you to stay in captivity. So when we teach our people, when we educate our people, they get mad. Look at us. They get mad. Read what you got.
Whosoever.
Okay, he said whosoever. Let me explain this, brother. He's not just saying whosoever. Let's get this. He's talking about John 3:16.
No, sir. Right there. No, sir. I'm talking about Romans 10:13.
We're gonna see what this liar, what these liars have been telling our people from the beginning.
Romans 10:13.
Chapter 2, verse 21. And it shall come to pass that whosoever,
keep that in mind,
shall call on the name of the Lord, shall be saved.
Read on.
Ye men of Israel.
Yeah, right. He said, hold on. Ye men of what?
Ye men of Israel.
Yes, right.
Hear these words.
Hear these words.
Yes, man.
You're going to call blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
Right.
Read it on the top again. I want Joshua 6.
Yeah, and it shall come to pass.
And it shall come to pass.
That whosoever
shall call the name of the Lord,
shall call the name of the Lord,
shall be saved,
shall be saved.
Amen.
Amen.
Of Israel.
Of Israel.
Romans.
Of Israel. Of Israel.
Romans. Of Israel. Of Israel. Of Israel. The whole
Hispanics and Native Americans. That's right.
His
word is not sown to all people. His word wasn't given to all people.
That's only
given to the 12 tribes of the children of Israel.
Chapter 18, verse 20. Jesus answered him, I spake openly to the world. I ever taught in the synagogue and in the temple, whither the Jews always resort.
So he always taught in the temple where the Jews resorted, right? So the word Jew is short for the name Judah.
That's right.
So he always taught in the temple where the Jews were. The so-called the Jews are black. The Jews are black. We're gonna prove that out of the Bible. Jewish is not in the Bible. If I say I'm coming to your house around 5-ish, am I coming at 5?
No,
I'm coming something like that, right? Somewhere around that. So if you say you're Jewish, what are you saying? You're something like a Jew? Yeah, you're kind of like a Jew? Okay, well the Jews are black. Let's see.
Jeremiah chapter 14, verse 2. Judah mourneth,
uh-huh,
in the gates thereof, right?
Says Judah mourneth in the gates language, meaning our leadership language is lacking. That's why the question that you asked about the pastors in the beginning is that's just the condition of that situation. Our leadership is lacking. Read on.
They are what?
They are what?
They are what?
Color is in the Bible.
They are what?
Uh-huh.
Unto the ground.
They are black unto the ground. Why? Why does it say that they are black unto the ground? Why does it say that? Okay, but I'm not going to tell you. I'm going to let the Bible tell you.
Genesis chapter 2 verse 7. And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground.
He formed man from what?
Of the dust of the ground.
What color is the dust of the ground?
Yeah. It's black, dark brown.
It's black, dark brown. The deeper you dig, the darker it gets.
Right.
So that means that prior to the so-called white man, who's not white, his name is Esau, he means red. Prior to him, there were only shades of brown on the planet Earth. There were only shades of brown. You understand that? So this is what we have to, this is what we have to come out of. The brothers brought out earlier that we're tearing down strongholds in the conditions of our people's mind. In the conditions of our people's mind, they said, we said we're black, the color of your jacket. Is that possible? No. God, it says that God formed man from the dust of the ground. You understand that? All right, read what you got.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 37. And thou shalt become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword among all nations, whether the Lord shall lead thee.
So the Bible says that you're going to become an astonishment. What does it mean to be an astonishment? An amazement. People look at us and shake their damn head like, these people right here, these black people are something else.
Yeah.
You walk around with tight pants on and sagging tight pants. How you do that? You understand that? But before we go any further, let's correct something right there. So we don't want our people in sin. You understand that? We have to let you know when you're in sin.
First Corinthians chapter 11, verse 3. But I will have you know.
You believe in this Bible? You believe in the Most High in Christ? Okay. All right, let's see. Great.
But I will have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
So the head of every man is Christ. This is an order that has been set up by the Most High God. So the head of every man is Christ.
And the head of the woman is the man.
And the head of the woman is the man. So if you have a wife, you're the head of her. Read.
And the head of Christ is God.
And the head of Christ is his father, God. Read.
Every man praying or prophesying,
uh-huh,
having his head covered, dishonoring his head.
So the Bible says every man praying or prophesying. That means reading the scriptures, hearing the scriptures, being a monk in the vicinity of prophecy. If you have your head covered, then you dishonor your head. So right now, with that hat on and the scriptures coming out, you dishonor him. You dishonor Christ.
What about the Kufis, the Muslims?
Well, the Muslims, they ain't got nothing to do with this because they have a whole nother book. They use a whole nother book, which is garbage. It doesn't pertain to them. Well, God says, every man praying or prophesying, if your head is covered, then you have to take your hat off when you listen to scripture. That is a commandment.
But every man praying or prophesying,
prophecies of this Bible are coming out. Did you not? Did you not get the understanding that you are an Israelite from the tribe of Judah today? What did that come out of?
Prophecy.
It came out of the Bible, right? So you're standing amongst the prophets. Read on.
Having his head covered, dishonored his head.
So you dishonor Christ when the scriptures are coming out and you have your head covered. Well, you're going to have your church. Y'all took it off, right? When you did go to church, you took your head off, right?
Yeah.
Right? So it will behoove you, if you believe in the Spirit of this Bible, if the Spirit bear witness with you, and you're listening to these prophecies, it will behoove you to take your head off while you're listening to the Bible, while prophecies are coming out.
Okay.
You understand?
All praise. Get that brother ahead. All praise.
Hey, come on. And don't be ashamed of that white woolly hair up there.
Yeah.
Because, hey, that right there is what Christ looks like. He has that white woolly hair. You understand that? All praise to the Most High. So we're here to teach our people according to the Bible. We have to come back, repent, and keep God's commandments. Do you know what it means to repent?
Yeah, to come back to the source.
Okay, how do you do that?
How do you do that?
I don't know, to read the word, I don't know.
Okay, we're gonna find out. Hold on.
The book of 1 Kings, chapter 8, verse 46. If they sin against thee, for there is no man that sinneth not.
So the Bible said, if we sinned against God, because there ain't no man that don't sin, read.
If thou be angry with them.
And he's gonna be angry with us, read on.
And deliver them to the enemy.
So he delivered us to our enemy. You see that right there? The transatlantic slave trade, the yokes of iron upon our neck. We've been delivered to our enemies.
So that they carry them away captive in the land of the enemy, far or near.
So we were captive. This has already happened. We were brought in captive to the land of our enemy. Remember, right now we are in the land of our enemy. We are the descendants of slaves who came here on slave ships,
right,
which is recorded in the Bible.
Verse 47. Yeah, if they shall bethink themselves,
so the Bible says, though we're gonna be led captive in the land of our captivities, if we bethink ourselves, what does it mean to bethink? Bethink. Bethink. That's an old great word. Bethink. It means to remember. If you remember, read that word again.
Yeah, if they shall bethink themselves.
Yeah, in this land where they're carried captive, if they shall remember themselves that you are an Israelite from the tribe of Judah,
right.
Read on.
In the land whither they were carried captive.
In this land where we were carried captive.
And repent. And make supplication.
Make supplication means pray to the Most High, say, Most High, I know that I'm in sin. I understand that I'm Israelite from the tribe of Judah. I wanna keep these commandments. I'm gonna do my best to keep these commandments. Guide me, Father. You gotta pray and ask for that. Pray.
Unto thee, in the land of them that carried them captive, saying, we have sinned and have done perversely. We have committed wickedness. And so return unto thee with all their heart and with all their soul.
So it says that we must return unto him with all our heart and with all our soul. Not this thing right here now. Not this, because this right here only pumps blood. It's talking about our minds. We have to return to the Most High with all of our mind. Meaning coming out of these doctrines like Christmas, Thanksgiving, the 4th of July. Coming out of all of these wicked holidays that they put on our people that we continually celebrate year after year after year. We have to come out of that. Read on.
We have sinned and have done perversely. We have committed wickedness. And so return unto thee with all their heart and with all their soul in the land of their enemies, which led them captive, and pray unto thee toward their land, which thou gavest unto their fathers, the city which thou hast chosen, in the house which I have built for thy name.
So it says that we must turn to our land, which is in the east. So you can't just go and pray. You have to pray and send your prayers toward the east and the land that he gave to your fathers. You send your prayers up in that direction because that's the land that he chose. And ask for forgiveness and repent, meaning return to God's laws, statutes, and commandments, and strive your best to keep the commandments. You understand?
Yes.
You understand that?
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.